హాయ్ హలో నమస్తే గుడ్ మార్నింగ్ గుడ్ ఆఫ్టర్నూన్ గుడ్ ఈవినింగ్ మీరు వింటున్నారు తెలుగు ఎన్ఆర్ఐ రేడియో ఇది ప్రవాసాంధ్రుల గుండె చప్పుడు నేను మీ ఆర్జే శ్రీదేవి ఫ్రమ్ బెంగళూర్ వెల్కమ్ టు స్పెషల్ లైవ్ షో ఈరోజు నిజంగానే చాలా స్పెషల్ గెస్ట్ అండి ఎందుకంటే తనకు తెలుగు రాదు సో ఫస్ట్ టైం నేను కూడా ఇంగ్లీష్లో తనని ఇంట్రడ్యూస్ చేస్తున్నాను వారి కోసం ఈరోజు ఇంగ్లీష్లోనే వెల్కమ్ చెప్తున్నాను సో ఎందుకంటే ఆమె స్పెషల్ మహిళల కోసం ఎన్నో సేవా కార్యక్రమాలు చేస్తున్నారు వారు ఆస్ట్రేలియాలో ఉంటారు స్వేరా అనే సొసైటీ ద్వారా మహిళల్లో కాన్ఫిడెన్స్ పెంచడానికి వాళ్ళకి స్కిల్ డెవలప్ కావడానికి ట్రైనింగ్ ఇస్తున్నారు సో ఆమె యొక్క సర్వీస్ చూసి మనం వారిని మీకందరికీ పరిచయం చేయాలి అని మాట్లాడుతున్నాను సో ఈరోజు మాత్రం ఇప్పుడు ఇంగ్లీష్లోనే మాట్లాడతాను ఓకే అండి థ్యాంక్ యూ సో మచ్ ఏ ఉమెన్ విత్ డెడికేషన్ డిసిప్లిన్ డివోషన్ అండ్ ద డెస్టినేషన్ ఈజ్ నన్ అదర్ దాన్ టుడేస్ అవర్ స్పెషల్ గెస్ట్ సొసైటీ ఫార్ ఉమెన్ ఎంపవర్మెంట్ అండ్ రికగ్నిషన్ ఇన్ ఆస్ట్రేలియాస్ ప్రెసిడెంట్ అండ్ మేనేజింగ్ డైరెక్టర్ ఫర్ A1 టీవీ అపార్ట్ ఫ్రమ్ దిస్ సిజే టీచర్ కౌన్సిలర్ అండ్ పర్సనాలిటీ డెవలప్ ట్రైనర్ పర్సనాలిటీ డెవలప్మెంట్ ట్రైనర్ conducted workshops for women empowerment to develop skill and confidence in women across the South Asia. She is here with us. Miss Sanajia, today's our special guest. Hi Sanaji, my hearty welcome to you on behalf of Telugu NRI Radio.
Hi Siri Devi, thanks a lot. Thanks for the introduction and then hello to all the audiences of Telugu NRI Radio.
Thank you. Sanaji, how are you?
I'm fine. What about you?
Very fine.
Thank you.
And how is their COVID situation in Australia?
Overall situation is good, but now because we are in Melbourne, Victoria, so Victoria is the situation is little worse at the moment, but hopefully it will be all right soon.
Yes. Wish like that only. Okay, Sanaji, tell me about yourself briefly.
As you already mentioned that, I am president of Savera, Society for Women Empowerment and Recognition in Australia. I am residing in Australia for nearly 10 years. And working at different sectors. Basically, I'm an educationist, so and now a counselor as well. So, when we work here, then I come across that there are so many ladies who are really very talented. They are highly educated because they are from South Asian background. And here, we always prefer education. So when they come to Australia, they are highly educated. But end of the day, because it's a different world. So that's why sometimes they didn't have that much confidence that they can go out and, try to look around for work and all that. So that's why I thought there is some sort of motivation which is required to motivate these talented girls or women to come on board and then, try to utilize their skills for Australia. And then secondly, there are few issues as well, like violence against women. And then, they have go through different problems as well. And plus, they don't know which is the best platform to go and record their problem and all that. Sometimes they hesitate because they don't know anyone here in Australia. So that's the reason that I think that we should have some sort of organization who help these kind of women. And super. If I can talk about my background, I did my master's in education and then in media studies as well. Later on, I did MPhil and now my PhD is about to finish. It's already finished actually now. I did a PhD recently from Australia in film and media studies. I also have a community channel which is A1 TV channel, and we try to promote diversity through this channel.
Super, all the best.
Thank you.
What was your motive creating Sphera?
As I mentioned before, because people from South Asian background, typically, if we talk about women, they just hesitate. like, you know, to go outside and talk to others, because it just, like, you know, due to lack of confidence. It's not they didn't have skills. I'm really proud to say that people from South Asian background, or particularly even if we talk about women, they are highly educated, highly skilled women. But unfortunately, due to lack of confidence, they didn't go outside. And they just try to limitize themselves at home. So that's why, like, you know, I just thought that we have to give them confidence that they have to explore Australia and plus try to utilize their skills. And that is the motive, like, you know, behind Savera. And I must want to highlight this, that, you know, from Savera, we are trying to give counseling services as well. Even as you mentioned, in COVID-19, people are going through depression, anxiety, plus they have financial issues as well. So through Savera platform, we are providing them counseling service where we, like, you know, it's a 1 hour counseling.
Where people need it.
Yeah. Where we just tell them that, look, there is look towards the positive side, or plus, like, you know, we just talk them, try to give them different options where they can utilize their skills so that they didn't feel negative or they didn't feel low.
Yes.
And that is what we are doing through Savera.
Very nice, Andy. Very nice approach.
Thank you. What
are the achievements and projects you have done through this organization so far?
Okay. There are different, because this organization came into being in almost end of 2018. So it's not too old, but still, like, you know, till from 2019 onwards, we are trying to do different sort of workshops to upskill women. Plus, like, you know, where we just tell them small, small things, which are a hurdle towards, like, you know, achieving high goals, or plus, like, you know, to get a good job. So we do upskilling workshops, like resume, how to write your resume, interview skills. Plus, we do different type of parenting workshops as well, where we guide them, like, you know, how to do or cope up with this situation when your kid is, like, you know, open towards a Western culture. So how a parenting is going to be changed. And then, like, you know, we provide them different sort of platforms where we organize different functions. Like, we do organize Eid functions, International Women Day, plus different small like, you know, Women International Day, plus kids special, and all those things where, like, you know, families come together, women come together, and then they celebrate to be as a woman, like, you know, the positive thinking, to develop positive thinking. And that's the approach we have. And plus, as I mentioned you before, that we started free counseling sessions from, like, you know, when, since the COVID-19 approach Australia. So we started different counseling services, which is available in 6 different languages, English, Hindi, Punjabi, Urdu, plus Arabic, Persian. We are looking for if there is any counselor which is available in Telugu as well. So let's see if we find anything, we can start it in Telugu as well. And this way I learn Telugu.
Just I'm going to ask about Telugu. You only said.
Yeah.
Okay, nice.
Yeah.
So as soon as you can get Telugu. Telugu teacher too.
Yeah, yeah, it's all right. Or otherwise I will learn from you.
Thank you. Okay. What is the importance to have an organization like Sphera in Australia?
I think it's really important. There are different organizations which are there. But unfortunately, people like us who are from different backgrounds, we are immigrant here. Sometimes we hesitate to go to these organizations. And the one thing which I feel is, like, you know, our issues are different than those who, like, you know, who are from, let's suppose, Australia, Canada, America. Because they are, like, you know, born and brought up here. So their issues are totally different than our issues. We have small different type of issues. So in order to cater the needs of particularly, like, you know, South Asian women or even the families, I think we should have some organizations who can represent people from our background. And, like, you know, this way, if anyone has an issue, it becomes easy for them to come to me and interact with me, because they know that I am from the same culture, from same background, And I do understand what trauma or anxiety or depression they are going through. So that's why I think we should have these kind of organizations.
So it's important for ladies, especially for women. You are saying so many issues facing women from different countries. For example, can you explain one or two issues? Which type of issues they are facing? How can you solve?
Actually, what happened, sometimes people come to us because I'm a teacher as well. And then I come across people who have, different backgrounds, Arabic, Persian, even in Hindi, and Urdu or Pakistani, Indian, all Bangladeshi as well. So what happened when these people come to us and then, when they talk about, always they said, now, if I have to talk in English, I feel hesitant. It's not they don't know English. It's just they feel hesitant. So we provide different sort of workshops where they, try to motivate them, try to give them a platform where they talk with each other. This way they can explore their skills. Secondly, the main issue which people come is violence against women. There are women who are from South Asian background, Bangladeshi, Indian, Pakistani, African countries as well. They are facing through different kind of violence, mentally torture and all those things, but they can't stand up because they don't know where to go. The men here, it's not everyone is like that, but they try to exploit
them. Some people are like that.
Because they are not financially stable women. They are dependent on their men. So they don't know how to stand up and raise their voice. I want to quote here one example, and that is I just recently find that last year, seven women from Indian background, typically they are from Punjabi background in particular, and they commit suicide here in Australia. And the reason which they find out is that they are all victims of violence. But these ladies just come to Australia, someone is 2 years before they come to Australia, someone just 6 months before come to Australia. There are few who are four or five years in Australia. And these ladies, it just they commit suicide because they don't know. They are socially isolated. Men didn't allow them to go and interact with other ladies. So that's why they are socially isolated. They don't know what is the best platform to go. And then end of the day, they find easy to commit suicide.
Oh, God.
So that is, I think it's a very thought-provoking for me as well. And it changed my perception that, look, people need your help. Because every life matter a lot. So that's why I thought during this time in particular, maybe we can't do anything for them. They already lost their lives and all that. But at this time, at least through counseling, that's why we are providing in different languages so that people can talk their issues in your language. They feel us friendly, and then they can
friendly atmosphere friends, you create.
Then we can share our problems. And then at least we channelize them where to go and what is the best place to go where they can raise their voice. And end of the day, at least we can save someone's
lives. Yes, yes. Very good thought and very good platform you are giving for the ladies, those who are sufferer.
Yeah, that is what we are trying now.
Yes, exactly. Excellent job, Andy.
Thank you, Sridevi. Thank you.
What are the difficulties you have faced being a woman to stand up and work for the community?
Yeah, actually, it is just there are so many people around who can help you. So I can't say that there are so many difficulties because in Australia, situation is different. There are so many organizations who are there to help you, to reach your message to a vast community. Plus, there are so many people. I must say that, I want to admire, there are a few other people as well, but I must say Venkat Annaji, Venkat Nukula, he is from South Asia, South Indian community, an active community member who is doing social work and plus a very active community member. And he always give me support and help. And then there are two others as well. Like, I want to acknowledge my husband as well, because he gave me that liberty to go out and explore and help others as well. And plus, there are so many other community members who always been there as a support. But still, the main hurdle which I come across is women didn't trust you straight away. They hesitate, or sometimes if you encourage them to speak up or at least stand for yourself or even for your kids, but they didn't find that courage to stand up and raise their voice. They think that, okay, the way we brought up that, okay, once you got married, this means end of the day, you have to die there and all that, So it's a mindset. We can't change them that, look, if you raise voice, at least, it can stop the trauma you are going through, and it is not beneficial or healthy for your kids as well. So if you don't want to stand for yourself, at least stand for your, kids. But sometimes, people listen, but most of the time it happens, end of the day, say no, people start isolating them. One more thing is, and that is, people bother all these problems for long, because end of the day, people from South Asian background, families, if any woman is separated, or even if they got divorced or something like that, people start segregating them. They try to avoid them. And end of the day, what happens that mostly we blame women. That, okay, you didn't know, you didn't understand your husband. You didn't fulfill his desires. That's why he's not good with you. They never question that, okay, if in a marriage or a healthy marriage, women and men, they both are equally responsible.
Main problem is understanding, misunderstanding, I think so. Problem is misunderstanding.
As well, people didn't trust even each other. They didn't communicate as well.
Yes, yes. Sanaji, 1 minute. One mobile caller is there. Hello, Andy. Welcome to NRI Radio. Ever matladutunnaru?
Good morning, madam. Neenu Ramana, madam. Kanchala Venkatramana. Ela unnaru?
Ramana, bagunnanu sir. Ramana garu, manato paatu unnaru. Sana garu. She don't know Telugu. If you want to ask anything in English.
Yes, yes. Yes, yes. Sanaji. Good morning, madam. How are you?
I am fine. Thank you.
Myself is Kanchala Venkatramana. I'm hearing your social, this one, services, and also the motivations. It's very good.
Oh, thank you. Thanks a lot.
And everybody needs that one.
Yeah, you are right.
Okay. Thank you, madam.
Yeah, thank you. Thanks
thank
for
you.
Your call.
Thank you, Ramana. Right.
Yeah. Thank
it's
you.
It's really ma'am. Appreciable that people like you encourage these things.
Thank you. Thank you for calling, Andy. Bye, Andy.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. Sanaji?
Yes.
What is identity? I mean, Sphera's identity to develop community forum in Australia?
Actually, it is first I just think about it that, okay, we should have some organization. I did few brainstorming. We do have a team of women. Want to do such community work, and then we have a vision and everything is there. And then again, I must say that, I asked Anna Venkat Nukulaji, and I said, look, I want this kind of organization. And he said, he's that kind of a person. He said, okay, we can do that. And I said, I know you can do it, but I don't know how to do it. And he said, it's all right. I will help you how to, do a setup or open this kind of organization. So I must say, he is the one who helped me. And then, whenever I have issue, I always go and ask, if I got any sort of issue, how to do it and when to do it and all that. So this is how we, we make Sphera. And plus, right now we are working on it. And there are a few other visions as well. I want to do an international conference in near future where we discuss different kind of issues. Due to COVID-19, it's a little bit delayed, but till next year, I think I'm hoping so that we will organize these kind of conferences.
Oh, nice, Andy. All the best.
Yeah, thank you. Thanks a lot.
And what are your future plans, Andy?
Future plan, as I said, like, you know, it's I want to do, like, you know, to organize different kind of conferences, plus we want to do different events as well, where like, you know, we want to promote those women who are entrepreneurs, like do small businesses, so we give them platform to grow. Plus, we want to organize more workshops, try to promote counseling, because people from South Asian background, when you said, like, you know, you want counseling or you need to contact any counselor, they think that, okay, straight away, they said that, okay, do you think I have mental problem? I don't have any mental problem and all that. So I want to tell others that, look, if you meet any counselor, it's not like you have mental problem. It is just a friendly talk. Counselors are different friendly than talk. Psychologists or psychiatrists.
Yeah, yes.
So it's not like, you know, try to change your like, you know, mindset. Sometimes every person in their life, they have through like face few ups and downs. So if that's in that situation, if you contact anyone, tell everything about what is your hesitations, what you are going through and all that. They are just there to help you, to guide you. That's it.
Yes. To show the right path for them.
Yeah.
Okay. One caller is there. We'll talk. Yeah. Hello, Andy. Welcome to NRI Radio. Every matlaadutunnaru. Hello.
Murlidhar Reddy Kuwait.
Murli sir, welcome. Manito paatu unnaru. Sanaji, speak with her.
Yes, Sanaji. Hi.
Hi, Murliji. It's how are you?
Good, good. Thank you. How are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
Okay, nice to hear that. I hear around 3-4 minutes back only, I started hearing about you.
Okay.
Doing excellent. Like a women entrepreneurship, supporting to women, helpless women or something.
Thank you.
It's an excellent idea.
Thanks a lot.
Best wishes. I have some women also, if you wanted to help them. I mean, you don't need to pay them or something else, but if somebody is ready to help them, in Gulf area, some husbands, sons, fathers died in Gulf, or migrants. So their families are abandoned in India. We are trying to... these families are BD workers. BD worker, they cannot gain anything, and they are not getting good income also from the society. If they cannot run a big business also, so paying the rents and shop rents or something else. If they are, if somebody is running shops or something. And some people are having medical issues. So if anybody comes in a trust or association, please support them. I'll provide some contacts, which they are highly educated, also like MBA, but they're unable to stand themselves. You don't need to pay them.
He also a social activist in Gulf countries. He helped a lot of people.
Yeah. I very active person. And